Hey guys, Tony the Soy Sauce Assassin. Welcome back to another episode of Cigar Review. All right, so this time we have another cigar, which everything looks just like a freaking Bahike, but you know, just because it has a tail doesn't mean it looks like Bahike. I don't know. So today's cigar is, let me get the name right, La Palina Goldie Laguito number 5 series 2. So it's a mouthful, okay? It's a 5 and 5/8 by 54 Robusto Extra with Ecuadorian Habano wrapper, Ecuadorian binder, filler from DR and Nicaragua. All right, with that information out of the way, That is the cigar right here. It really doesn't have much thing that would tell me that it's a Goldie, except that you just have to know this is a Goldie. Okay? Nothing that tells me so, I don't know. I'm kinda... smell just cedary, there's nothing to it. Anyway, this cigar is priced about $24, I believe. $24. So this cigar better be really, really good. Really, really good, because I don't know. If it's not, why are you paying $24, right? Cotton light. Looking good. The draw is on the tight side. I'm kind of worried now, but we'll see. Now, Eric says that he have some serious expectation over this cigar because he actually liked the cigar, but we will see how that turned out. Lighting it up. Give it a good toast on the side, brush it through. Oh, okay. The draw is tight. Give it a little bit of massage. Tastes like a really floral cedar. Tastes very, like, I don't know. That's... tastes like a woman's perfume or something. Like a... how do I describe that? A perfume. A female floral perfume. Yeah. A little bit creaminess. Maybe just that much pepper. I don't know. I might have to cut the cap some more. The draw is horrible. I don't want to destroy this cigar. So we'll see. We'll see if this gives me some mercy. Yep. Can't give too much information since I have no draw. I'm smoking it for a little bit and we'll see. I'll be right back. All right, so roughly about 1/3 of the way through. Of course, not before I pull out something like this. Yeah, It was all the way through. There was another one that I tried to pull because it's a lot of stem in there. But this one broke when I was trying to pull it. I was like, halfway is better than nothing. So, overall ash, not too bad. The flavor, it's like a perfuming, floral, hay, cedar going on. Now, there is a little bit of pepper too. It's actually quite flavorful. I mean, if you think about this, it's quite flavorful. And it tastes pretty good. I don't hate it. I think it's kind of interesting. But I don't see $24 though. I don't see $24. I see maybe $18 at most. I don't know. This is a re-release. Apparently it sold pretty good before. And they re-released this. But it had to bring me something more. I had to keep smoking this down. And they had to give me something more to be a $24 cigar. Right now, probably $18. Because I just don't see it. Lady, where's all the flavor? I went from the bottom up. I don't see anything. What the hell? You know? All you have is give me some woody. That's all you give me. So, yeah, we have to continue to smoke this in a little bit. And hopefully it gives me something more because right now it's very little of anything other than flavor. And you're like, Tony, this already got a flavor. What do you mean look at everything? Well, I feel like the flavor is good but very one-tracked, single-elemented, you know, kind of thing. It's like not a lot of thing going on. You got very good, very strong, perfumey, like, floral hay. You got a little bit of sweetness. You got cedar. And maybe some pepper. And that was it. It's like, you tried to be a Connecticut cigar? I don't know. Maybe there's some creaminess, but then, like, I haven't gotten enough to feel that way. I feel like right now is not enough. Not enough to be $24. So, let me smoke this down. Be right back. Okay, two-thirds of the way through. So, now I understand why they had charged you $24 because you buy one, get one free. Buy a cigar, get a tree. Why? Here's what I got out of this cigar. So, when I first started smoking the cigar, it was plugged. So, I tried to pull a stem out. I got this. Pretty much entire cigar. See that? And I tried to puff a little bit. It got a little bit better, but still no draw. Pull another one out. Well, this one, I tried to pull it out, but it broke halfway. All right, fine. Still tried to smoke it way down, halfway down. Figured it would loosen up, but it didn't. So I found another big fucking knob, and I decided to pull it out. I got a tree. Yeah, this is not leaf. This is a fucking tree. See that? This whole thing is a stem. This is hard too. This is a stem too. So yeah, you get a tree. But other than that, now that it's got a draw, I tested again. The flavor is the same. All right. So you get a little bit of cedar. You get a little bit of creaminess. You get a lot of floral, a lot of floral. Get some hay. You get some pepper. That's all you get throughout. Now, does it taste good? Okay, it kind of tastes kind of good, right? It smell and tastes like a floral perfume. Very nicely put together. But if you give me a cigar that's impossible to smoke, how am I supposed to taste that? Anyways, so this thing is $24 MSRP. I think this is worth $8. $8 for what I get out of it. $8. It's a poorly constructed, poorly done cigar. Maybe that is the only one that does that. But you gotta understand, as a cigar smoker, you go out and try a new cigar and this is what you get, you probably will not try another one again. $24, would you risk another $24 for that? When you can probably buy two more cigars and smoke and not worry about that. I will buy two more cigars or some other cigar that I don't have to worry about that. So you really don't have that chance to mess it up if I'm trying the cigar for the first time, right? No, as a cigar smoker, you wouldn't. So, but here's the band. Here we go. Very understated, like, you know, old Victorian style band. There's nothing to it. What I didn't like is there's nothing tell you that this is called Goldie. There's nothing tell you what size it is. It's nothing. Just that single band. So looks nice, but lazy, man. No, $8. So yeah, let me smoke the rest of it. Hopefully no more issues. Let's get to the summary. $24. All right, finally. Barely does anything, so yeah, $8 cigar, if not less. I don't even want to go any lesser than that because it would not be no point. But I would like to do a public announcement to the cigar makers. This thing adds no value to the cigar. I don't know why you guys keep saying there is. It doesn't have any flavor to me. It doesn't do anything because this thing, it doesn't burn. Like, what is the point of this thing? Like, it's just there for me to try to burn through. This, you see, this thing doesn't catch on fire. This thing has no straw. It doesn't really burn anything. It doesn't burn. Like, what is the point of this? What is the point of this? Like, why? Why? Don't put this in there. It doesn't do anything. It doesn't add any flavor. It doesn't really smoke anything. Don't. I know you want to fill it in as structure, but you don't need this. You definitely don't need this. You don't need one. You don't need two. You definitely don't need three. You definitely don't need the tree. I don't know, like, what it's supposed to do with this. Like, what is the point? What is the point? There's no straw. There's nothing. There's nothing. Why? Why you do that? Bad. 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 So yeah, the cigar is not very enjoyable because the construction of this one is not very well. It could be just this one and like nothing else, but all it takes is one for me to review to tell you this. So unfortunately, that's the case. $8 cigar, if not less. Not worth it. The flavor, yeah, it's interesting, but it's not interesting enough for me to go through all that problem. It really isn't. So, you know, there might be some people that get a good one and enjoyed it. But again, that flavor alone don't justify $24 ever. So I would say not worth it. Skip it. If you save that $24, there's plenty of cigars that's $24 you can buy better. I really feel so. All right. So yeah, that's it for this particular review. If you like it, like, subscribe, and share and comment. If you don't, I don't blame you. I feel like I review a lot of cigars that disappoint me, but it is what it is, right? I smoke it, so you don't have to. You don't have to waste your money, right? So, yeah. That's it for this review. I'll see you guys next time. Hopefully, better cigar. Bye, guys.